everyone, and welcome to the Ospreys at Belmont Bay on this incredibly beautiful September evening here in Northern Virginia.
Just look at her sitting there, sweatpants, t-shirt, and a comfy chair. Hair in a bun, one hand on a mug, and the other one's playing snare to a George Strait vinyl day. Yes, I know Lionel get her close, but I don't think she can understand just how far I've been letting my heart fall. What's in my head? She don't know I got some big, big plans. Build a little house out on some hand-me-down land. Find a little island where we go to get tan. Bet we take our kids down there one day. And I know she wouldn't mind if I did a little something like find a fly. Overnight to paradise and late tonight. And I'ma put a diamond on her hand. She don't know I got some big, big plans. Johnny Emerald Diamond on a brand new band. Asked her mama for permission and her daddy for hand. I got some big, big plans. Build a little house out on some hand-me-down land. Find a little island where we go to get tan. Bet we take our kids down there one day. And I know she wouldn't mind if I did a little something like find a fly. Overnight to paradise and leave tonight. And I'ma put a diamond on her hand. She don't know I got some big, big plans.
She don't know, she don't know.
She don't know I got some big, big plans.
She don't know, she don't know.
Well, here I go, cause right now we're back in her hometown. And I'm down on one knee. I guess she finally figured out I'm gonna ask her to marry me. Some big, big plans. Build a little house out on some hand-me-down land. Find a little island where we go to get tan. Bet we take our kids down there one day. And I know she wouldn't mind if I did a little something like find a fly. Overnight to paradise and late tonight. And I'ma put a diamond on her hand. She don't know I got some big, big plans. She don't know I got some big, big plans.
She don't know, well, she don't know.
You say you'll be down in 5. The smell of your perfume is floating down the stairs. You're fixing up your hair like you do. I know that I'll be a mess the second that I see you. You won't be surprised, it happens every time, it's nothing new. It's always on a night like tonight. I thank God you can read my mind. Cause when you look at me with those eyes, I'm speechless. Staring at you standing there in that dress. What it's doing to me ain't a secret. Cause watching you is all that I can do. And I'm speechless. You already know that you're my weakness. After all this time I'm just as nervous. Every time you
never be long enough for me. Feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do. Now that the weight has lifted. Day.
Teamwork, a mutual respect, a healthy dose of admiration, and a never-ending portion of love and grace. Fawn Weaver. Welcome again, family and friends. I, along with Barb and Jason, thank those who are able to physically be here to witness them as they start their new beginning. They thank you all for being a part of their journey thus far and are very grateful for your love and support. We are making special mention of Barb's children, Allie, Caitlin, and Austin, and of Jason's daughters, Jordan and Lexi. Barb and Jason want to thank them for the love and support they have shown in preparation for this day and tell them how very much they are all loved. Barb and Jason would also like to acknowledge those who are unable to join us physically here today, be it by distance or passing on from this physical plane, as they are strongly present in their hearts. And today is a celebration. Oh, no, no, that is absolutely not gonna work. Let's try this one more time. It's gonna be that kind of wedding. Today is a celebration! Woo! I knew you had it in you. A celebration of love, of commitment, of friendship, of family, and of two people who are in it forever. You don't have to have a ceremony to have a marriage. And when you think about it, this whole thing is kind of stressful, huh? Yeah, yeah. So why do we do it? The marriage ceremony has been an important feature across nearly every culture, religion, generation, and society. We have thousands of important moments that happen throughout our lives, but this one is regarded as so critical. We acknowledge its special status by sharing it with others. Why? Because despite all our differences, love is what we all share. It's the great unifier, our one universal truth. That's why Barb and Jason are standing here today. That's why you, beloved family and friends, are all here to join them in celebrating this special moment. We have all loved in our lifetimes, and in this moment, we're reminded that the ability to love is the very best part of our humanity. As fate would have it, Barb and Jason first met almost 2 years ago in October 2018 through mutual friends at Jason's bar Eclipse. Barb remembers thinking that Jason was cute and a little shy when they first met. Jason remembers thinking that Barb was beautiful, smart, and easy to talk to. I'm told that Jason asked Barb out for the first time by sending her a private message on Facebook, asking her to go on a cruise with him.
Really?
She responded with a resounding no, multiple times. But she did thank him for asking. Jason asked again when he saw Barb in person a week later, and she suggested maybe they go out on a date to dinner. You think? They did go out on that dinner date and many other dates in the next couple weeks. Barb did eventually say yes to the cruise, and she and Jason have been together ever since. Timing, my friend, is everything, and destiny is patient. The rest, as they say, is history. Barb and Jason, you have chosen to enter together into the sacred covenant of marriage that you both believe is a commitment of partnership between two people who love and respect each other. Barb, you also believe marriage is about prioritizing the life that two people continue to build with each other. Barb, you admire Jason's sense of drive, his love of family, and his sense of humor. Jason, you admire Barb's smile, her sense of humor, and her energetic personality. I think some others may resound that too, I don't know. Barb, you say you know that Jason is the right person for you because you just fit in all the right ways. With Jason, you feel at peace and at home. Jason, you know that Barb is the right person for you because she brings peace
and happiness to your life that you didn't know was possible. Barb and Jason, you both want to convey how lucky you feel to have found each other and how much you love each other. We will now have a reading by Kyle.
So, I'll be reading The Art of a Good Marriage by Wilfred Marlon Peterson. Happiness in marriage is not something that just happens. A good marriage must be created. In the art of marriage, the little things are the big things. It's never being too old to hold hands. It's remembering to say I love you at least once a day. It's never going to sleep angry. It's at no time taking the other for granted. Courtship should not end with the honeymoon. It should continue through all the years. It's having a mutual sense of values, common objectives. It's standing together, facing the world. It's forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It's doing things for each other, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It's not looking for perfection in each other. It's cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. It's having the capacity to forgive and forget. It's giving each other an atmosphere in which each other can grow. It's in finding room for the things of spirit. It's a common search for good and the beautiful. It's establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal, dependent is mutual, and obligation is reciprocal. It's not only marrying the right partner, it's being the right partner. Discovering what marriage can be at its very best.
Thank you, Kyle. Well, good, you're already holding hands. Barb, please repeat after me. Jason, these things I promise you. I will be faithful to you and honest with you. I will respect. Help and care for you.
Help and care for you.
I will forgive you.
I will forgive you.
As we have been forgiven.
As we have been forgiven.
I will be your trusted travel companion.
I will be your trusted travel companion.
On this journey through life.
On this journey through life.
Do you, Barb, take Jason to be your wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do you part? If so, please say, I do. Jason, please repeat after me. Barb, these things I promise you.
Barb, these things I promise you.
I will be faithful to you.
I will be faithful to you.
And honest with you.
And honest with you.
I will respect.
I will respect.
Help and care for you.
Help and care for you.
I will forgive you.
I will forgive you.
As we have been forgiven.
As we have been forgiven.
I will be your trusted travel companion.
I will be your trusted travel companion.
On this journey through life.
On this journey through life.
Do you, Jason, take Barb to be your wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do you part? If so, please say, I do.
I do.
This is the point in the ceremony where we usually talk about the wedding bands being a perfect circle with no beginning and no end. But we all know that these rings do have a beginning. Rock is dug up from the earth, metal is liquefied in a furnace at 2,000 degrees, then molded, cooled, and painstakingly polished. Something beautiful is made from raw elements. Love is like that. It comes from humble beginnings made by imperfect beings. It's the process of making something beautiful where there was once nothing at all. May these rings remind you of your promise to accept each other's imperfections and to always recognize each other's beauties. As this ring is placed upon your finger, remember that it is your love for one another that brought you here, and that it is love that will guide you down the pathways of your future. Thank you. Barb, please repeat after me. With this ring, I marry you.
I marry you.
And bind my life to yours.
And bind my life to yours.
It is a symbol. Of my eternal love.
My eternal love.
My everlasting friendship.
My everlasting friendship.
And the promise.
And the promise.
Of all my tomorrows.
Of all my tomorrows.
Perfect. Jason, please repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I marry you.
I marry you.
And bind my life to yours.
And bind my life to yours.
It is a symbol.
It is a symbol.
Of my eternal love.
My eternal love.
My everlasting friendship.
My everlasting friendship.
And the promise.
And the promise.
Of all my tomorrows.
Of all my tomorrows.
Excellent. Beloved guests, you are here for a reason, and it's more than just a fun reception. Please take a moment to look around at your fellow guests as you are part of this couple's community. Are you willing to be a circle of trust for this couple? As you help hold them accountable for their commitment of partnership, and will you promise to encourage and support their dreams? If so, please respond with, "We will."
We will.
I believe you. We are now going to have a unity sand ceremony. Barb and Jason, your marriage is not just the pledge between you two. It also includes Allie, Caitlin, Austin, Jordan, and Lexi, who will also share your lives.
Then God whispered your name, and that's when everything changed. And love came out of your brain. And talk about being saved.
Pouring the sand into the larger vessel represents the joining of your lives together, joining and blending as a family, each person bringing their own characteristics into the mix, each a unique part of the beautiful whole, each container forming its own pattern just as each individual has their own unique personality and part to play within the family. The whole culminating in a one-of-a-kind creation, just as your family will be one-of-a-kind, a work of art, a thing of beauty, grit, and all. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated or returned.
Barb and Jason, as you have both vowed to join your lives in holy matrimony, by the power vested in me, by the state of Virginia, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Jason, you may kiss your bride. I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Fliss.
I can still see that dress you were wearing with those yellow wildflowers. I can still smell that vanilla in your hair, one hand in the pocket of my worn-out jeans. That summer night did something right. Still hard to believe.